Well, hi everybody. Here we are, live at last on YouTube. Sorry for those that we had to put off on Wednesday. We've had all sorts of issues here this week, particularly with the internet. Some dear workmen have managed to cut one of the cables near us, so it's been a bit of a sort of traumatic time. But yeah, it's great to be with you. I can see we've got people online. If you want to send any messages, you are very welcome just to show me you're there. If you've got any questions, you keep them to yourselves. No, you can ask me, of course you can. Just if anybody's watching that's not sure what we're all about, my name's Paul Carman. I'm the owner of Keyboard World. Hi Phil and Babs, nice to see you online. And Keyboard World is an idea that I've had for quite some years now. And basically it's an online interactive magazine. So we can embed things like videos. Excuse me one second, I'm just gonna turn my microphone down just a tad, because it's just peaking. So we can embed videos, we can embed audio, and I have to say the reaction has been great and membership is building up very, very nicely. We also run monthly webinars for subscribers, and in fact we had one last night, that featured Steve Hubble from Korg UK. So we had something like 60 odd people on live. It's had 600 views overnight. So yeah, we're really, really pleased with the way it's going. I can see some messages, so you're gonna have to excuse me today because I'm on my own. So I'm having to monitor YouTube, switch my cameras, play some music for you and read that, and I'm getting to an age where it's not possible to do all these things, but we'll do our best for you. Somebody's asking if this software we're going to show is available for Korg PA5X. It will be very, very soon. Obviously this things sort of things take time, and we are getting there. Let me talk to you a little bit about what we are going to show you today. For the last 30 years, I've worked with a guy called Dave Medcalf, who is, first of all, a great musician, great guy. He's also a prolific style writer. And between us over the years, we've created lots and lots of styles for different makes. And to start with, we picked Genos 2. Not that we think the onboard styles are not good enough. There's some amazing styles on here, but what we've tried to do is write some styles that are a little bit different to those built in. Now if I just put my screen on for a second, you can see the sort of styles. Some of these are general styles and some are song dedicated. So we've got Air Ballad, I'll be showing you that one. Albatross, the Fleetwood Mac. Another Day in Paradise, Phil Collins. I'm going to start with this one, the theme from Bilitis. We've got Careless Whisper, we've got a country pop one there, we've got Go West, we've got Hey Jude, a bit of Michael Bublé there, we've got Magic Rock, which it's a kind of magic, It's My Party, Morning Has Broken, My Guy, etc. We've got a total of 23 styles. I think by the time we actually launch, which will be in about 2 weeks' time, because although all the styles are finished, I've now got to do the work on the website and get everything. And I have to be honest with you, as of next Tuesday, I'm nipping off to our home in Spain. I'm gonna switch my phone off, I'm gonna switch my computer off, and I'm actually just gonna take a break for a week. But as soon as I come back, look out on the website, the Keyboard World website, everything we're showing you today will be available. So these styles, I'm going to play you some snippets, and here's another disclaimer. I've spent that many hours, and so, I mean, Dave's put so many hours in on this, and when you're working on these styles and creating voices and things like that, you actually forget to learn the tunes that the styles go with. So it's been a mad panic in between other things this week, just to really actually learn some pieces. And look, you know, I'm not going to hide the fact, here is my iPad, and I've managed to download some basic docs, but it will be warts and all today. So I'm amongst friends, hopefully, so we'll give it a go. All of our styles will contain three intros, they'll contain three endings, they will contain all four variations, there'll be breaks, all the fill-ins are there, and each one, I've just finished doing this, will have four one-touch settings with it. So let's have a look. This first one, I used to play this in the late 70s, and it's a lovely piece of music, and have a listen to the style, and I'll show you as many of the sounds as I can as we go through. So this one's the theme from Bilitis. So there you go. That's the sort of quality of the styles that we're doing. A few questions come up. No, there isn't 10 registrations per style. We've done the four one-touch settings. I'm going to come to some other software that we're doing where we have put 10 registrations in. Somebody's asked, will they work with Genos 1? Yes, the styles will. I'm just, as soon as I get back from my trip next week, I will be getting access to an original Genos. I just need the instruments to put the settings in. They'll also be available for SX700, SX900, and then ultimately we will go on to the Korg system there. Let's try another little style. This is a song from the 60s, way before my era. But it's a little thing called It's My Party. Great little style, this. And again, we'll use the four one-touch settings with a bit of luck. Goes like this. There you go, that's It's My Party. What we've done for the ending there, if you notice, I didn't change chords for the whole of the last chorus. We've made the last chorus the ending, so you can just sort of play along with it there. Let's move on to something totally different. Now, this style came about by me ringing my colleague Dave, and I said, you know, a song I've always wanted to play is Albatross by Fleetwood Mac, and it's got such a unique backing to it that, yeah, we can use a basic sort of 8-beat ballad rhythm or something, but it just didn't sound the same. So bless him, Dave set about writing this style, and I think he's captured it really, really well, and then he's passed it on to me. We've put some guitar sounds and things like that, so hope you enjoy this. This is a little bit of Fleetwood Mac and Albatross. Thank you. There you go, complete with the seashore as well. But yeah, that is a really unique style, because if you want to play Albatross by Fleetwood Mac, you need that dedicated backing to it. So we've heard some song styles so far, but we're also very aware of the fact that song styles are great, but often you can only play that one particular song to it, and that you need some general styles as well. And this is something a little bit different, I think. We came up with this one. Originally, this is one that Dave used to use on his gigs quite a lot, and we've changed it around a little bit. Now, I'm a great believer there's no right or wrong with a style, because you should choose the style you want for that particular piece of music. And what I've done here, I've listened to the style and I thought, what could I play to that? And actually, I've come up with something just a little bit different for this one. I think it works with the song El Condor Pasa really well. So I'm going to do a little bit of that. The actual style we've called Air Ballad. It's quite an ethereal sort of style, but I hope you'll agree. I think it works. Question there coming in from Arizona in the USA, and he's saying, typically how long does it take to create a song style? Some of these styles are 1 or 2 days solid work, because getting the style together is one thing, then Dave will ship it to me, you've then got to revoice it and rebalance it for the actual instrument that it's going on, and then put the one touch set in. So on average, if you say a couple of days, 2.5 days per style, it's quite a lot of work. It's quite a lot of work goes into it. So this is our style called Air Ballad. Hope you like this. Thank you. go. Hopefully that's something a little bit different. And like I say, you don't always have to go for the obvious. And I think things like that sometimes can keep things interesting for you, to not always use the obvious style. There's been a couple of little comments. Yes, we had a few technical glitches at the start of the webinar last night. And what I'd like to say to all of you is, obviously, a lot of this is new to us. We've got the magazine, we've inputting the digital data into the magazine. We're trying to run webinars. We're trying to do live sessions. From time to time, I apologise, things might go a little bit wrong while we're getting used to all the equipment. But I'm sure we'll get there in the end. And I'll reiterate what I was saying earlier. All we're trying to do, obviously we're running a business, but we're trying to create a nice, friendly keyboard community. Somebody said, why don't you start a forum? I have this sort of pet hate about some of the forums because they tend to generate anger. And I don't want that. I just want people to enjoy what they're doing and hopefully enjoy what we're doing as well. So let's have a couple more styles. And then I'll go on to show you some different type of software that I'm also working on, and then we'll come back to the styles just to finish off. By the way, my thought is to start these live sessions on almost a weekly basis. And as soon as I get back from Spain, if you want more of these type of things, and we can cover all sorts. I mean, obviously today is a bit of an advert for our software, but we've got the Korg PA5X here in the studio. We could do a session on that. We could do some more on Genos. We can do whatever you want. So in the comments, if you can, just let us know if you'd like this type of thing to become a regular thing. And what we'll try to do, if at all possible, is arrange it for sort of the same time. And funny enough, Eileen's just said anger not allowed in my forum. But I think you know what I mean. You tend to get on many of these forums, not all of them, I understand that, but on many of them, you will get people who tend to dominate and they have the loudest voice. And I really don't want to have to get involved in moderating forums and things like that. We'll carry on as we're doing it. But yeah, just put in the comments if you'd like to see this on a weekly basis at a regular sort of time, then yeah, quite happy to do it for you. Let me just grab a drink. Hope you've got one too. And all right, any day but Tuesday at 3, because that's when Alan's go live. Yep, we'll try not to clash with anybody else, Sue. Just one little style just to finish. This is something totally different from what we've done. This one's called Smooth Swing. So totally different style. And again, there's hundreds of songs that would fit this. I just happened to pick this one this morning, and we'll give it a go. It's called It's Only a Paper Moon. Have a listen. It is just a nice laid back sort of swing sound. When we get to variation C, just listen, there's quite a nice string line comes in there. So here we go. Smooth Swing goes like this. Thank you. Okay, I tell you what, I said that would be the last style, but I'm going to show you this one. Now, this will be wrong notes and everything, because believe me, or you have to believe me, I've never actually played this piece of music, which is a former organ player. This is a bit of a crime, really, but this style is based on a very famous Klaus Wunderlich arrangement of a piece called Tico. And as I say, genuinely, I don't play the piece, but I am going to try and bluff my way through it just for the benefit of showing you how the style goes. So please, you're just going to, I'll make no apologies for this. It'll be what it will be, but we'll give it a go. So this is something totally different from what we've shown you so far. Klaus Wunderlich, like this. Plenty of mistakes in that, and but maybe what I should do is each time we do a live webinar is play it each time, and eventually I'll probably get it right. But hopefully you're seeing the diversity of the styles, hopefully you're seeing the sort of quality of the styles that we're actually producing. Now I'm gonna put my screenshot on again, because I want to show you some different sort of software that we're working on now. Now these are where we filled all 10 registrations up, and what I want to do is basically just to go through a couple of the completed categories and one that I'm currently working on. And as we said earlier, all of this software, about 2 weeks to get it just finished and uploaded onto the actual website, but we'll email you when it's all ready. So the first section I've done is Pops Orchestra. These are the things that everybody always seems to ask about. We've got Burt Camfort, we've got anything prefixed with JL is James Last, and we've got things like Morning in Cornwall, Mornings at 7. RC is Ray Conniff, we've got Spanish Eyes, believe it or not. You know, if I had a pound for every time I'd played that, I wouldn't be here today. I'd be sitting on a beach somewhere. But still a lovely piece of music. We've got Herb Halpert and the Tijuana Brass. Let's start with a little bit of James Last, Morning in Cornwall. Now, although this doesn't use new styles, what I've done is I've spent quite a lot of time editing the original style, and revoiced it sometimes, just rebalanced it. And I've certainly worked very hard on the actual right-hand voicing. We've done edits and things like that. So what I also want to show you is basically just a selection of the sounds. And the format I've done this in is that the first button every time will always, let's go back onto the overhead, sorry. The first button every time will generate the correct intro. And when you get to the last button, button 10, that will automatically generate the ending, so you don't have to mess about touching intros and endings. So just a little bit, not the full piece of Morning in Cornwall. So there you go, 10 registrations in there. I've done something different on some of them. Let's use Spanish Eyes as an example. Oh no, not Spanish Eyes. Yeah, let's use Spanish Eyes. What we've got here, if I just go back to my main screen, the first 5 registrations are untransposed. But then when we get to 6 to 10, I've actually put it up one semitone. So again, you haven't got to worry about using the transpose, and it gives the piece a nice lift. The only thing you've got to bear in mind, once you've gone beyond button 5 and you're on to the transposed, try not to go back to 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5, because they are untransposed. But let's just have a listen. It goes like this. Ooh. There we go. A little bit of Spanish eyes. Yeah, Sue's made a really good point. And you can put the freeze on and then go back. I'm just talking in general if you don't want to press any other buttons. But yeah, Sue, absolutely spot on. You could use the freeze button and that would enable you to go back to the first five settings. But hopefully you get the idea of what we're doing here. Let's just try the Tijuana brass. I need the music again. This is bad, isn't it? Let's just have a look. Do you know, I can't think what the first one's called now. Let's have a look. Yeah, the Lonely Bull. So this one's split into two. The first five registrations are for the piece, The Lonely Bull. And then 6 to 10 are for Tijuana Taxi. And in the Tijuana Taxi one, I've actually set up a split on the keyboard there as well. So you'll hear the brass sound down here and the marimbas up there. This is genuinely water. I wish it was gin, but it's not. So here we go. Remember, 1 to 5 is one song, 6 to 10 is the other. Go. So a little bit of Tijuana brass. So these are all popular pop orchestra type things. Somebody's just put on, can I play some rock style? That's not unfortunately what today's about, but I'm happy to do that on another session. Just one more from this section, just because it's just something a little bit different, little classical piece. And again, I'll just play a part of it and I'll rush through some registrations. How are we doing? Yeah, we've got about another 20 minutes left. So, and I'm only saying that because I've only got so much battery left in my little mixer here because it's been on overtime today. So we'll do about another 20 minutes with you. But this is called Intermezzo. And it's a little classical 3/4 time, just again done in the style of James Last. So we'll work through the 10 buttons. As I said, you might find I'm changing registration more than I should be. I just want to give you some idea of the sounds. Okay, let's just go back to the, or go over this time to the country file. Again, 10 songs, 10 registrations for each. Some really nice, I've worked hard on some of the sort of country violins, and there's a fantastic sound on here called Dobro guitar, which is, have a listen out for that. It's a sort of, it's a metal bodied guitar. And it's this sort of sound. And you can imagine the guy sitting in his rocking chair in the Western movies, you know. It's that sort of sound. But let's just show you a couple of these. First one is Your Cheating Heart. Goes like this. Questions coming again about this working on Genos One. In about a fortnight's time, I will have access to a Genos One, and I will copy these registrations as close as I possibly can and make them work on Genos One. I don't know, let's do maybe a couple more from here. This one's the one by the Carpenters, and it's called Top of the World. These are just little snippets. So all I want you to see is that we're working on two different types of software. One is the styles, and the other is editing the internal styles and putting the 10 registrations with it. Let's go back just to finish with just a few more styles here. Let's see if you remember this one. By the Pet Shop Boys. So this is again different. Again, this is a little piece called Go West, and Again, we've used, a bit like in the other one, I can't remember what it was now, but we've used the chorus as the ending. So when you get to the end or the final chorus, just press the ending and you can play along with it. Let's have a little try of it. I've got to remember how it goes myself, but hopefully it's like this. So that's a little bit of Go West. This next one is more of a general style, and I love this one, and I love the style, and it's only this morning that I came up with a little piece that I think fits it really well. So it's another film theme, this one. It was written by a guy called Marvin Hamlisch, who wrote some superb music. And again, this is more of a sort of ethereal type style, but I think this works really well for this. So it's the theme from Ice Castles. Thank you. There you go. So, look, we have, as I say, 23 styles. They will all be up on the website, let's say 2 weeks' time, to be absolutely certain. Genos 2, wonderful sounds, wonderful styles. I love playing it. In fairness, I love playing the Korg as well. So they've both got their attributes. I just wish we could combine the two together, but hey, we're not going to be able to. Couple more styles to finish. This one's called Swing 5. I think the title speaks for itself. It's this one. Take 5. Really hope that you've enjoyed this little informal session, and I will get in touch with everybody as soon as I'm back. So there won't be anything next week, but maybe on the Friday the following week I will put something. But you will be emailed, it will go up on the YouTube channel, it'll be advertised on Facebook. All that remains is to say thanks for your support today. I'm surprised how many people we've had on, considering this is the first one. If you can spread the word for us, that would be great. And I look forward to seeing you all very, very soon. All I can say is thanks for watching, and we'll see you again sometime. Bye for now.